Hi guys, welcome to the channel. So as a part of this video, I'm going to take a mock interview for the skill manual testing with one of my subscriber. Her name is Nikita. She's a fresher. So let's welcome her. Hello. Hello.
Hello, sir.
Can you enable your video?
Yes, sir, yes.
Hi, Nikita, how are you?
I'm fine, sir.
Okay.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm good, Nikita. So you are a fresher, is it?
What, sir?
You are a fresher?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay. Can you tell me something about yourself?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Nikita Mani.
Nikita, going forward, call
what,
me Manish.
Sir?
Call me Manish.
Okay, sir.
Tell me.
Myself, Nikita Mani. I completed my engineering from Srimati Kashibai Navle College of Engineering, Pune. I love to work so that I can utilize my education in right way. Coming to my technical skills, I had done software testing course at Cyber Success Pune. I have a knowledge of the core Java, SQL. My short-term goal is to get placed in a reputed company, and long-term goal is to become a respectable position in that organization.
Okay, that's good. From which branch you have done your engineering?
Mechanical, sir.
Okay. Is there a particular reason why you are shifting from mechanical to testing field? Just wanted to ask.
Yes, sir. Actually, sir, when my engineering is completed, my engineering completed in 2019. From 2019, there is a very recession in the mechanical field. And also my interest is changes to the software, because in my company, in my colleges, there is a not single company come to the college for the campus placements. Okay. And my interest also changed to the IT industry.
Okay.
So I decided to switch the IT industry. And so that's why I had done the software testing course.
Okay. So you think one day you will achieve success in your software testing field?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That's good to hear. Shall we start?
Yes, sir.
Are you nervous?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Little bit, sir.
Okay. Nikita, call me Manish. Okay. I just wanted to tell you that don't be nervous. Even though you are not answering something, that's totally okay. I'm there to help you. Maybe at the end of the meeting, maybe through mail or telegram, anywhere. But even though you're not answering something, that's totally okay. I'm very happy that you came here,
sir,
to have an interview with me. Let me tell you that many people out there don't have the courage to come here in front of me. You have that courage. So be happy for that.
Yes.
So let's start the interview.
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me what is the purpose of doing the testing?
Yes, sir. Actually, testing is done for a specific reason. When the developer develops the software, there is a person to test the application, whether this application is defect-free or whether this application run according to the customer requirement or not. For that reason, we test the applications.
Okay. Are you sure that when you are testing some software, you will give error-free software to the customer? Are you sure about it? Just asking.
Actually, sir, it is impossible to send the software defect-free. But we are trying to launch the software defect-free.
Okay, that's interesting. Okay, just tell me one thing. Tomorrow you are testing something.
Sir?
Maybe you are hired in some company. You are testing some application. You got some minor defects.
Yes, sir.
You got some minor defect?
Yes, sir.
And will you still release the software?
Actually, sir, this is authority to the test lead or test manager. This is not authority to the test engineer to launch the software. But if the authority is responsible to the test engineer, I will not launch the software if the defect is present.
Okay, Nikita, I just want to tell you, because you are a fresher out there and many fresher people will be watching this video. When you are joining some company, let's do not depend on my senior QA or my QA lead. You are the QA engineer. You can take the responsibility of telling to the company that we are not going to release the software to the customer. If it has, feel that defect is, that defect can break something. So it totally depends on the QA engineer. If Nikita is tomorrow joining some company, it is Nikita who need to say to his QA lead or QA manager that I don't think that this software should go to the customer. And I feel that this minor issue needs to be fixed, and then it should go to the production. The reason I'm telling to you, because as a QA engineer, you should never be silent. You should speak.
Okay, sir.
See, QA engineer role is to, like, you can do a lot of things. You can do a lot of things with your speaking skills. You have to speak.
Okay,
when you have tested something, you have got the issues, you have to raise it to the concerned people. You have to raise it to the QA lead. You have to raise it to the QA manager. You should not say that, okay, whatever the decision you are taking, I will be happy with that. No, you should. You know the application, right? And you have found out that bug. Now it is Nikita or the fresher guy who has joined the company who need to take a decision whether he really feel or she really feel whether this software should go into the production or not. You have to speak is what I'm trying to say.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I understand that. Yeah. Totally understand. I totally agree that if really it is a minor bug, you can say that, okay, even though we are going to the production, there is no issue in that, but you have to explain. You have to explain the severity of that bug to your QA lead or QA manager. You need to make them agree why you are saying that this bug cannot go into the production. Getting me?
Okay, sir.
What I'm trying to say here to all the freshers out there who is watching this video is you need to speak. You learn to speak, not when you are becoming senior QA engineer or QA lead or QA manager, but as a fresher. That will be very advantage for your career. Okay, Nikita, that's really impressive answer. Let's move to the next question. Just tell me, tomorrow, if you are going to some company and you are the only software tester out there, you are the first QA hired in the company, and there is no requirement, they just give you the application to test it. What will be your approach? Which kind of testing will you will be doing?
Okay, sir. In this situation, I will do the exploratory testing because there is a not requirement. Firstly, I will understand the application, how applications work, and then I will test the applications. In that situation, I will do the exploratory testing.
Okay. Sure. Just tell me one thing. If I give you a login page of any application, any bank application, let's say, or any application, any application, let's suppose. I just tell you that test this login feature. What will be your first approach?
Okay, sir. Sir, if there is a requirement, then we check the requirement for the login page credential. Means in the login page, there is a first name or the last name. That time we firstly check, there is a means we firstly do the functional testing that this login page accept this last first name accept the means capital letter or the small letter, or it accept the alphanumeric, or it accept only the numeric. Then we also derive the all possible scenarios and test this login page.
Okay, so you're telling that you will first understand the requirement. I was looking for. That's a great answer. Thank you. So you just tell me one thing. If you join tomorrow some company, let's say it's a banking company, banking domain company. It has a transaction field, amount field, which says that amount text field can accept amount between 50,000 to 1 lakh rupees in a particular one day.
Yes, sir.
What kind of scenarios that you can think of? How you will break this particular feature?
Okay, sir. For the amount transfer, firstly we means apply the test case design technique for 50,000 to 1 lakh. Firstly we check for the valid options, that is between the 50,000 and 1 lakh. We check for the 51,000, 50,000, 60,000, and we also check for the invalid numbers, that is 49,000 or 20,000, and check whether it is properly means it is acceptable or the not.
Okay, so you said you will apply here boundary value analysis.
That's it. Yes, sir. All design techniques, test case, equivalent partitioning also, boundary valueness also, and the error guessing also. But boundary value analysis is the most proper test case design technique more wide coverage of the test cases.
Yeah, I got it. That's brilliant answer. Thank you. So you are really a fresher, is it?
Yes, sir. Fresher,
I am. Okay, you are answering really nice. I am sure that
yes, thank you, sir.
You are one of the topper in your college or school. Is it so?
Means, sir, in mechanical engineer, I was topper, but in IT industry, I'm facing interviews, but I'm rejected.
Hey, no issue, man. Nikita, I will tell you one really a good story. What do you think today? Am I doing good in my life, in my software testing field? You think so?
Yes, sir.
Do you really agree with me? I mean, do you really think that I'm doing good in my software testing career?
Means you or I? I'm
me. What you think that? Am I doing good in my life, in my software testing field?
Actually, I just watch your videos. So from this experience, I thought that you are doing a good in your life.
No, obviously, I'm doing good in my life. But what I wanted to tell you that when I started giving job as a fresher, I was rejected in my first 10 interviews, and I was selected in my 11th interview. So that's totally okay. I mean, even though you're not getting selected now, I'm sure that you will get selected. I mean, there is no need to tell your heart to be hurt. Just work hard. You will get selected. I'm sure that you will get selected. No issue.
Yes, sir.
Tell me one thing. When developer will say that a defect is not reproducible, he's not able to reproduce it.
Yes.
When he will say that?
Okay, sir. Not reproducible means tester is able to see this defect, but developer can't see this. This is a defect present in the software. This is due to improper build, platform mismatching, due to improper defect report created by the test engineer. There is a condition that technology is not supported by that particular features. Means suppose there is a Gmail application, and that time some users use the application login page. So this developer's technology is not supported by this login features. That time also a developer said this is not reproducible, or if the defect is under the minor or the major category, that time also a developer said that this is not reproducible.
Okay, good answer. Thank you. Good answer. Can you give me two positive and two negative scenario to test my WhatsApp application?
Yes, sir. WhatsApp means firstly positive application. Positive scenario is that in WhatsApp application there is a video option also.
Don't tell me a story, but just tell me how you will write your test scenario. I want to know how you are framing the test scenario. Is what I'm looking for. That's all.
Okay, sir. To test the search number, it's display or not. It is a positive scenario. Negative scenario.
Okay, means whatever the search contact detail you have saved, you are checking in WhatsApp. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Got it. Tell me.
Or negative is that in my contact list, suppose there is a one contact, suppose Shah Rukh Khan, and in WhatsApp I search the Shah Rukh Khan and it is display on the WhatsApp application. This is a negative scenario.
Okay, tell me one more negative scenario.
In WhatsApp, we call the video call to the particular contact number, and this video call goes to the another contact number.
Okay. But
means we call the some particular person and the call goes to the wrong person.
Okay. That's possible, correct? But okay, whatever you are telling is absolutely correct. But I will tell you one negative scenario that you can test it is. Let's say that in a WhatsApp feature, in a video call, let's say that maximum people that are allowed to do video call together, let's say it is 8 number. I don't know the exact number, how many people can do a video call together.
Yes,
sir.
Yes.
Do you know the number?
Yeah. No, actually, I don't number, but this is also.
I am not sure about. So let's say in WhatsApp, there is a limit that only 8 people can do a video call together. And now the scenario is you are adding the 9th person, whether allowing it or not. That's a good answer. Thank you. Can you tell me what do you mean by end-to-end testing?
Yes, sir. End-to-end testing is nothing but the system testing. In end-to-end testing, we test the all the steps. Means let's consider Amazon application. In Amazon application, we log in with the our current credential. We put the credential, log in, and that time we search the product, add to cart product, then buy the product and payment the product. This all testing means we test all the features of that application. This is nothing but the end-to-end testing.
Okay. Yeah. Got it. Okay. Can you give me any integration test scenario in any application? Let's say in WhatsApp.
Okay, sir. I will sir in Gmail application. Suppose there is Compose application. WhatsApp. Okay, sir. We write the message and send it to a particular person. A write the message and want to send the message to the B person and send the message to the B person. That time B was online on the WhatsApp and he also sent the message sent by the A. This is also integration testing.
Okay. Yeah, that's impressive. Can you tell me what do you mean by formal testing? Heard about this term before?
Yes, sir.
Hey, Nikita, how come you know everything?
Yes, sir. Because in lockdown, I'm trying very hard.
Hey, that's good, man. That's really good. Frankly speaking, I took many rounds from the time I said that I will be taking rounds, many people came for the interview. I took many freshers interview, but I even took many rounds for freshers where they started shivering. And I had to stop the camera and I had to tell them that, okay, take care. But you are really impressive. That's really nice to hear. That's why I got to know that you are a topper in your college or school, right? That's impressive.
Yes, sir.
Continue, formal testing.
Thanks, sir. Formal testing is a type of the smoke testing. In formal testing, suppose test engineer write the 20 test cases. Out of these 20 cases, 15 test cases are passed and 5 test cases are not passed, means they are failed. That time test engineer said to all technical team that this application is not accepted, means test engineer rejected this software. After that, developer fixed that defect and sent to the test engineer. Now test engineer refer all these 20 test cases and test the applications and this test engineer documents all the test cases. Means this is in the formal testing. Test engineer should documents all the test cases, or documentation is a very important thing in the formal testing, formal smoke testings.
Okay. I got it what you said, but I just asked about formal testing. I didn't ask about formal smoke testing. I just asked about what is formal testing. Any idea?
Miss, informal testing. What, sir? Sir, actually my connection was loose.
Hey, no. What I'm asking is, like I didn't ask you about formal smoke testing, but I asked you about formal testing. Have you heard about this term, formal testing?
Actually, sir, I've heard about the formal testing is a type of the smoke testing.
Formal testing is a type of smoke testing. Okay. I will tell you what is formal testing. Formal testing is nothing but, see, there are two kind of companies. One company where you're able to hear me, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
There will be two companies. One company where they will do not document anything. They will not document your test scenario. They will not document your test.
Yes, sir.
They will not document your bug tracking. They will not document your traceability metrics. They will not track your defect tracking. They will not track anything. They will not track anything. That company is called.
Yes, sir.
That kind of testing is called as informal testing.
Informal. Yes, sir. I knew it.
I know that you know, but I'm just telling, no issue. And then there comes the formal kind of testing where test engineers, they write test scenarios, they write test cases, they write traceability metrics,
yes.
They write bug tracking, they send report, they do everything.
Yes,
they do everything in a very formal way. That is called as formal testing. Getting me right?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now just tell me, in a formal company, in a formal testing, whether they will conduct postmortem meeting or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Have you heard about the term called as usability testing?
Yes, sir. In usability testing, we do not test the functionality of the application. We only check the user friendliness of the application. Means how the application is user friendly. Is application able to use the all the end users or not? In user friendly testing, we only check the user friendliness of the applications.
Can you give me some ideas by which you will say that this application is user friendly?
Okay, sir. Let us consider, sir. Suppose there is a AutoCAD application. Actually, AutoCAD is not user friendly because suppose we have to draw the some line. But in AutoCAD application, there is an option like a draw. Inside draw, there is a line. Inside that line, there is option also 2D or 3D. Means we have to select the options inside. Means inside draw, there is a line. Inside line, there is a thick or thin. Inside that, there is a 2D or 3D. This application have a two or three more clicks. Means this is a not a user friendly applications. User friendly application means suppose there is a shaadi.com website and there is a so many options like where use means who will means looking for a groom or bride, or also there is so many options. So we fill all the form and click on the submit, and that time there is no loading time. Means this is a user friendly applications. Means loading time is not taking too much time.
Okay, sure. Okay, what I was looking here is what I was expecting here is whatever you said is absolutely correct. But what I was looking here is, do you know the meaning of placeholder?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what it is?
Yes, sir. Placeholder means suppose there is a login page and there is a first name text field And suppose we put the our cursor to the means text field of the first name. That time this application shows that this is the first name.
Okay, got it. Yeah, that's what I was telling. When you say your application is user friendly, your application should teach the user how to use the application. Do you agree with?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, whatever you said is absolutely correct. No issue. I just gave you an idea, or to everyone who is watching this.
Yes.
We can tell even this option or even this answer. No issue. Absolutely great answer.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Can you tell me which model is called as iterative and incremental model?
Agile model, sir.
Tell me something about agile model.
Yes, sir. In an agile model, both testing team and development team working simultaneously, so that when the project is assigned to a particular company, that company spend this means launch this software to the customer in a very short span. This is a big advantages of the agile model. In agile model, there is a various roles are there, like a scrum master, product owner, or the QA team, or the QA team.
Okay, just tell me one thing, whether tomorrow if you are joining the company, can you become scrum master or not?
No, sir, I will become a scrum team, but not a scrum master.
Okay, what do you think a scrum master, what characters he should have that you are not having?
Yes, sir. A scrum master is a person who only notice the what is the means how is the process is going on, whether the team is working properly or not, whether the product is launched to the customer is as per the customer requirement or the not. A scrum master is not the is a person who is not responsible to the not responsible for the quality of the product, but is responsible to the all the activities which is done during the project.
Okay, fine, impressive, but fresher, it is hard to become scrum master. But tomorrow, if you are joining some new company, let's say, or a startup company, and you have almost of two or 3 years of experience, that time they can make you scrum master. And your job will be to take update from each and everyone, what they did today, what they are going to do today, what they did yesterday, and is there any blocker for them? Instead of product manager or product owner involving in this stand up daily, they can make you scrum master, and you have to take an update from your type team members and update to the maybe your engineering manager or QA manager.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. Have you heard about the term called as release notes?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Release note is a document which is created by the test engineer. It's contain how many defects present, which defects are the fixed, which defects are going to be the fixed, how many test cases are passed, how many test cases are not passed, or how many total test cases are the there. Means it is a documents where all the things are the noted, and it is also and in this document it also mentioned that what is the procedures to install the software.
Okay, impressive, great, thanks Nikita. My next question is, can you tell me what according to you should be the top qualities of any software tester? If you have read this question anywhere, erase it off, but I want to know from your point of view, what do you think the top quality should have, any software tester should have?
Yes, firstly quality is to find the defects more and more, test engineer should think beyond such a limit, so that the software is defect free. and the test engineer should be test engineer should be think more than means means common common thing.
Okay.
And test engineer should have a quality for the for communication also.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good answer. Thank you. Nikita, can you tell me a few differences between retesting and regression testing?
Yes, sir. Firstly, regression testing is testing the unchanged features, to make sure that this unchanged feature is not impacted due to some changes like fixing the defect, adding the features, or many more changes to make sure that these changes are not impacted to the unchanged features. And retesting means suppose a developer developed the software, and this software sent to the tester. Now tester tests the defect. Now tester tests the application, and suppose he found the defect. That time he sent the build or application to the developer. That time developer fixed the defect, and again send this application to the tester. Now this tester do the testing. This testing is called as a retesting.
Okay.
Means retesting means the testing the defect, testing the defect which is fixed or not.
Got it. Yeah, yeah, absolutely good answer. Thank you. Do you know what performance testing, what it is? Not the practical knowledge, but just the theoretical knowledge. Do you have?
Yes, sir. Tell me. Performance testing means testing the stability and response of a time by loading the by applying the load. It is called as a performance testing. Where stability means ability to handle the number of the users, and the time response time means suppose we in Gmail application, suppose we enter the means we enter the username password and click on the login, that time homepage is displayed, means this is a response time. And load means how many users use the application means at a one time. This is nothing but the response time.
Great.
Performance testing.
Yeah, your answer is really awesome. I mean, just wanted to ask you, like, do you really watch my channel regularly?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Mm-hmm. Have you heard about severity and priority?
Yes, sir.
Tell me about it.
Severity means impact of the bug on the business workflow, and priority means importance given to the bugs to fix it.
Okay. Can you give me an example where severity and priority both are high?
Yes, sir. There are four types of the severity: critical, blocker, critical, major, and minor. Example of the high severity and priority is like, suppose there is an application like we go to the browser, and suppose there is a www.gmail.com, and suppose there is a firstly there is a login page, and we enter the valid details, means username and password, and suppose we click on the login page, that time homepage is not displayed, means this is a high severity. And priority is that suppose we enter the website www.gmail.com, and that time a login page is displayed, and in that time suppose we enter the username password, and suppose there is a login page have a spelling mistake, this is also the high priority, because when we enter the gmail.com and enter the valid details, login is also means it is the first page to display the all end user. This is also high priority.
Yeah.
To fix that bug.
Yeah, sure. Have you heard about the term called as Big Bang method?
Big Bang. Actually, I remember that this is a type of the integration testing.
Exactly.
But sir, I'm not clear about that.
Okay. Finally, first question that you're not sure of. No. I'm sure that you know even this definition. I will just give you an example. You will get to know. Have you heard about the term which is called as non-incremental integration testing?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Tell me about it.
Our non-incremental integration testing means in that testing we don't know about that who is a parent and who is a children. This is a non-incremental.
Who is the child module?
Yes.
Okay.
Who is a parent module and who is a children?
Okay. Tell me. Is it all? Tell me more about it. I mean,
is a definition
non-incremental integration testing. How they will do the testing?
In non-incremental integration testing, we don't know about who is the parent module and who is the child module.
Okay. No issue. So see, in non-incremental integration testing, you do nothing but, since you are not aware of which is a parent module and which is a child module, you mix all the modules.
Yes, sir.
And now you check the data flow between them. Now you check the integration testing between them. So this is called as non-incremental integration testing.
Yes.
The other name that is given to non-incremental integration testing is nothing but Big Bang method.
Okay, sir.
It is just the other name of non-incremental integration testing.
So non-incremental.
You know even this one, right?
Yes, sir.
Great. Can you tell me how many principles are there in software testing? Have you heard about this?
Yes, sir. Yes. It is mainly about 7 to 8.
7 to 8. Okay. It is exactly 7. Tell me any 5.
First principle is that firstly, to find the defect. It is first principle. Second principle is it is not impossible to launch the software defect free. Third, where we should not do the exhaustive testing. Fourth one is a cluster defect, and the fifth one is a
pesticide.
Pesticides, yes, I don't recall this. Pesticides paradox.
Okay, can you explain this? What it is?
Suppose there is an application and which contains the 4 to 5 model. Let us consider 4 model A, B, C, D. And
Pesticides. You were telling me that one, right? What you were answering was defect clustering, right?
Defect clustering. Yes. Paradox. Yes. Actually, I'm not recalling. I know that, but I can't recall it.
Hey, no issue, man. See, pesticides paradox is nothing but, if you are not update, I will just start. In case you are able to remember, just start from there.
Yes, sir. Yes.
If you run the same set of test cases for a longer run, you will not be able to find out the defects.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Tell me about it.
Yes, sir. I recall it. Suppose consider a one feature. For this feature, we create a test cases and we test these test cases, means set of the test cases again and again. And that time our defect is limited. So we have to update our test cases. Means we have to add some more scenario to our test cases so that our test cases coverage is wider. So that's it.
Okay. What you have said is almost correct. But so what I was telling is, if you have the same old test cases for a longer run, that means, let's say my sprint is for 10 days, and after every 10 days, I'm releasing the soft piece of software to the customer. Now I have the set of test cases. Now if I run the same test cases, same set of test cases every time, I will not be able to find out the new kind of defects. This concept is called as pesticides paradox. To come out of this pesticides paradox, we should keep on updating our test case document. Maybe after every 2 or 3 releases.
Okay, sir.
Okay, brilliant. No issue. Can you tell me something about smoke and sanitary testing?
Yes, sir. Smoke testing means testing the basic and critical features at a high level to make sure that application is working properly or not. And the sanity testing means testing the basic and critical features at one step deeper. Means suppose there is a Gmail account, and in Gmail account there is an inbox. In inbox, suppose there is a mail. In smoke testing, we only checks that in inbox this particular mail is present or not. And in sanity testing, we test that in the inbox there is one mail, and we test that whether this mail is forwarded or not, or we are able to reply to this mail, particular mail, or not. This is a sanity testing. And smoke testing is a wide and shallow testing, and sanity testing is a narrow and deep testing. And smoke testing is a positive testing, and sanity testing is a combination of both positive and negative testing. Smoke testing is automated, but sanity testing is not automated. And in smoke testing, there is a need of the documentation, but in sanity testing, there is no need of the documentation.
I will just tell you one scenario. Just tell me whether you will perform a smoke or sanity testing.
Only scenario or example, sir.
I'm going to tell something. You just tell me whether you will perform smoke or sanity here.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Okay. Tomorrow you are joining some company, and that software which you are working on, which you will be working on, it already had 1040 releases already. It happened, and now developer has given a new build to you. You will do smoke or sanity first?
Sir, can you repeat, please?
Okay.
Please.
Tomorrow you are joining a company, and the software which you are going to work on, that software is already released 1040 times into the production. And now software is giving you a new build. When you are receiving a new build, whether you will perform smoke testing or sanity testing?
Smoke testing, sir.
Okay, Nikita, I have uploaded a video which is like smoke and sanity difference on my YouTube channel. I would request you to watch that. No issue. Usually fresher will be not be totally understanding what is difference between smoke and sanity. I will tell you. See, until your build is not at all stable, right? Let's say tomorrow you're working in some new company, and until and unless your basic and critical feature of the application is not stable, you will perform smoke testing. Once your system is stable, once your software is stable, every time developer is giving you a new build, you need to perform sanity testing. No need to worry. I understand this, but I have uploaded a video on this topic. Yes. It is available on my channel. Just have a look. I have mentioned 9 points. I'm sure you will understand it. No issue.
Okay, sir.
Hey, Nikita, it was really nice talking with you. If I have to give any feedback from my side, definitely, I'm sure that you're doing good in your life. You have a good knowledge of software testing. Really speaking, I'm sure, frankly speaking, what I was looking for, you had all the capabilities, you had all the answers, and all the answers were absolutely correct. I'm really impressed. I'm sure that in next 1 month maximum, I'm going to receive a mail from you saying that Hi, sir, or maybe hi, Manish. The reason I'm telling hi, sir, because even after telling Manish, you call me Manish, you kept calling me sir. Okay. So I'm sure that after 1 month down the line, I will receive a mail from Nikita saying that, hi, Manish, I got placement in this company. I'm sure you will get placed because you have a good knowledge. And I wish you all the success.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
I wish you all the success.
Yes, sir. I will. Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Yes, sir, I will also try to place the company as soon as possible, because